Have you heard about Clavister's VPN client? OneConnect is an easy-to-use solution to access all your corporate resources over an encrypted SSL connection. And today, we're going to show you how it works. Let's start with the NetWall side of things. Stefan Lindqvist, our partner support engineer, will show us how to configure it with self-signed certificates.
We go into the network and the VPNs, OneConnect. We add an interface, and then we set a name. In my case, I used OC. Then we go down to the inner IP, the IP that we basically connect to the firewall from the inside of VPN. And then we set the outer interface, where they connect from, and from to what IP they're connecting, basically. Then we set the host name. That is basically what they enter in the client to get connected. Authentication source. We have a local database prepared. We just call it database, and we have a pool to give the client IPs. And below we have the netmask of the network. Then we have a DNS, and that's the interface completed. Now it comes to the more tricky part, if I say so. The certificate. This is where we get tickets about, basically. I have a self-signed certificate here, pre-made. The important part here is that either issuer or subject matches the host name. Otherwise, the firewall will not present the correct certificate. Basically, you get an error, it will connect. However, we need to set it also. So we go to remote management, advanced settings. And here we have the HTTPS certificate, and we set it to self-signed. That way the firewall knows this is one I should use when it comes to it. This is a pretty basic setup that we have in the KB article also. That is pretty much detailing it on how to set it up. There are more types of setups in the certificate that we have documented on the KB articles, and we have more articles coming also.
And now, let's see how it works on the application side of things with Jörgen Isaksson, one of our software developers, who's going to show us the brand new iPhone application.
So this is what the new application looks like when you have no VPN configurations installed. You are presented with a welcome screen, and you can scan a QR code to add a configuration, or you can add a configuration manually like you could before. But one of the new things is that we have a standard traditional navigation bar at the top. So I'm pressing the scan QR code button. We have a code, and I'm scanning it like this. So I'm presented with the add VPN configuration screen, and I can just add the password for this configuration. And for the first time, when you add the configuration, the system will ask you to allow to add the configuration. So I allow it. And as you can see, the SG demo configuration is added, and I'm just ready to connect. So I press connect, and I'm connected. And the old VPN configuration profiles are available in the upper right corner. So you have the configurations here.
Thank you for the demo, Jörgen. So can you tell us, what was the biggest challenge while working with the OneConnect applications?
I think one of the biggest challenges was to have support for all the major platforms and have native support for all the native platforms. So currently we have support for OneConnect on Windows, on Android phones, on iPhones, on iPads, and on Macs. So all those platforms are covered. And we decided to write all the applications in the respective native tools on each platforms. So it's not a cross-platform application. It's an application that is native on each platform and takes cue of each platform's look and feel.
What can you tell us about the future of OneConnect?
Yeah, we are constantly working with adding all the security updates to OneConnect as soon as we know about them. We are also working with new ways to authenticate, like with Apple's passkeys and FIDO2, for example. And traveling between different networks is a hard problem to solve that we are working with, like from mobile to Wi-Fi, for example. Mm.
You can download the OneConnect applications from the various app stores. Just click the links in the description. I'm also leaving links to our knowledge base articles to help you configure a whole range of scenarios. And we'll be back next month for more, so don't forget to subscribe to be notified of the next video coming out. Thank you for watching and stay safe.